Mr. President?
Yes.
I move that the Canton City Schools Board of Education approve the transition agreement that is before all of us, that is signed by Adrian Allison, John Rinaldi, and Jeff Gruber, for the purpose of making it official.
Second.
Open the floor for comments and discussion.
Mr. President?
Yes.
I want to begin my comments this evening by thanking the public for patience. Whenever these things happen, people have rights, they have constitutional rights, and there's a lot of law. And you know, a lot of times it looks like the parties are withholding information when in fact we're just following the law until something is executed. And tonight, tonight we move into a little different phase in that this agreement, you know, will become public in a few minutes. And the board is committed to being as transparent and deliberate and to continuing to work in the public's interest. And I thank the public for patience with us. We are here because in December, Mr. Allison elected to separate from the Canton City School District, and we are following through on his wishes. I, for one, and I think I can speak for most everyone on the board, thank him for his years of service to the Canton City School District and wish him and his family nothing but the best going forward. It is not an easy job to be the superintendent of the Canton City School District anyone who steps up to do it, especially for a number of years, deserves a lot of credit, and I acknowledge that this evening and wish him and his family well. The agreement, which will become public momentarily, is the work of attorneys and recognizes the need to respect and protect all of the parties. It is a mutual decision. I am both honored and very proud to be sitting here on a Board of Education that has treated this professionally, deliberately, in a conscientious manner from the very beginning until now. We have been very unified, and I think we have served the needs of the community to the best of our ability, and I'm very grateful to all of my colleagues at this table for how this was handled. And with that, shortly, this board's 100% focus needs to turn to academic performance and student achievement. It's what we do as a district, and it's why we're here. And in the narrative that has been around this issue for a while, some of that message has gotten garbled, which is why I'd like to take a minute to comment about it this evening, because it can get garbled. On September the 13th, this district was notified by the State Superintendent Paolo Di Maria that we were 1 year into academic distress. Most of that is because of our academic performance and student achievement. We have been addressing that as a board for quite some time. This problem did not start this year. This problem has been creeping up on us for a number of years. And it's not going to go away immediately. But the state is now mandating that we deal with it. When I read the newspaper, the repository on Sunday, I was particularly insulted by the front page editorial. And I was insulted because the editorial board of our newspaper of record decided to mock the idea of student achievement and academic performance in a very open and outward way. And the reason why I was insulted is because that was an insult to every one of our students, to every one of our employees who come to work every single day knowing full well that that's why we're here. It is not a little thing. And the reality is, and this is also tied to this, is that that is a superintendent's responsibility. That's why we hire them. That's where the buck has to stop. And as we go forward, you, the public, need to hold us accountable for making sure that the position of superintendent is filled with the best possible candidate that can lead this district going forward toward higher student achievement and academic performance, and hopefully out of academic distress. This is not the place to talk about what the consequences of academic distress are. We've started to talk about that. We're going to talk about it a lot more as the year unfolds. But it is a dire situation, and it is very serious, and this board takes it very seriously. And the reason I bring this up is because in the narrative that has been out there, this is what has gotten lost. And this board cannot lose that focus. And speaking for myself and confidently on behalf of my four colleagues up here, I don't think that we will lose focus of that. But again, I thank the public for your patience and your understanding, and I'm looking forward to the next chapter that begins tonight for the Canton City School District. And I'll give it back to you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Resnick. Any other comments from the board? Mr. Milligan.
I regret very much that we have arrived at this moment. Adrian Allison is a good man of great faith who gave his heart and soul for years and years to Canton City Schools, who was educated here, raised here, family here. And I just regret that we've come to this place. He has a good family. very committed, totally committed to our community. And he, during his time here, and I don't think anyone on this board would dispute this, was committed totally to the well-being of this district. And so I regret that we are where we are. And I would say that the burden is now on this board to convince a person of equal or greater quality and capability to come and be first an interim superintendent, because we need one, and then to convince a person of his caliber and quality to join us and work for this board as their superintendent. And that is a big job, and it's something that this board needs to commit itself to do what is necessary to convince a person of that quality that their place is in Canton City Schools. And so I think that's a burden that we all share and we must meet. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Milligan. Any other comments? The board members. I would just like to state first and foremost, I'd like to thank Mr. Allison for his 5.5 years of service to the community and 5.5 years of his work with the district and with the transition of where it rests today. We recognize that that journey wasn't easy. As you look at the agreement, the separation is mutual and everyone is satisfied. For those of you who have attended our board meetings and our study sessions, you have witnessed a tremendous amount of time that we have spent in the last 2 years working towards achievement, working towards discipline, and continuing to focus on the financial health of this district. Some of those meetings, 2, 3, 4 hours long, not a standard board meeting, but a study session where interactive discourse is welcome. We have spent a lot of time. We've had a lot of great discussions. We have discussed the struggles that we face. When you look at the education system in Ohio, some people say it's rigged. Absolutely, it's rigged. It's rigged to score the lowest performing. But the thing that we can't say is that it's rigged evenly across the board. As you look at our numbers, we can see over the last few years, we haven't done very well, and we recognize that. But if you look back at the journey that we have had, some great discussions, we have identified those things, and as we sit here tonight, the journey changes. And I echo Mr. Milligan's comments now that we need to find a new leader. And as we move forward, the focused next steps of the journey, we will be appointing an interim superintendent. The nationwide search for a new superintendent with OSBA will start immediately. We will continue the study sessions as we have for the last 2 years or more to keep driving to get out of House Bill 70 and its grip. So the focus hasn't been lost. School superintendents and districts are judged across the state at various levels. You know, the bar has been set by the state. You know, in essence, they're the enemy. We know the rules, we know what's ahead of us. I know that this district has the strength to do everything it can with its community, with its staff, and with its partners. It's a tough road to hoe. But with all those folks that I just mentioned, I know that we can get there. So in closing, we thank Adrian for his work. And we have a lot of work to do. Thank you.
Any other comments? Mr. Gruber, call the roll, sir.
Mr. Russ.
Aye.
Mr. Deller.
Aye.
Mr. Milligan.
Aye.
Mr. Resnick.
Aye.
Mr. Mulligan.